Good afternoon. We're here because this morning, some of our citizens and residents of Troy found themselves in an impossible situation. This morning, two buildings owned by Mr. Greg Messingale had their water turned off. Those buildings are located at 38 Fifth Avenue, where the families of Mac and Joyce Henderson and their three children reside. And we also have another apartment over at 684 Second Avenue, which is the home of Alyssa and Lamont, and they have two children there as well. There's also a mother and her disabled son at that location, and another gentleman who has chose to move on. Mr. Messingale owns approximately five properties in the city of Troy. All of them are without water at this time. Mr. Messingale has managed to amass $9,000 plus in water bills. Unfortunately, his tenants, who are paid up, and in one family's case, they are paid until January of next year, they have found themselves without services today. And because the city chose to turn off their water, not only are they without service, they are also forced to move within the next 72 hours. Because as we all know, if a residence has no water, it has become deemed uninhabitable. As I said, this is no fault of any of the families that are being affected by this. For some reason, it seems that our families are being used as shields, and in some way, figuring that if we bargain with our families, that we'll get the landlord to pay. We have a lot of rules and codes and regulations and so forth on the books that are not being enforced, and this is symptomatic of a larger problem. However, our families find that they have no homes and that they're faced with having no water, all at the expense of someone else, someone else's mistake.
The city and the landlord had a verbal agreement with each other. It was said that the water would stay on. Somewhere down the line in the last 24 hours, that verbal agreement has been broken. There was another agreement that has been broken. The notice on the doors states 10-10-14. That agreement has been broken. The reason this agreement has been broken because you have individuals in the city of Troy that has nothing to do with the situation, that has nothing to do with the situation, but has a mouthpiece to put into somebody else's ears to harmful these families. Yes, these families are in harm. These families are suffering. It's not that this didn't happen overnight, but this did. The problem didn't happen overnight. $9,000, that didn't happen overnight, but this did. They turned around and came this morning and just went out there and did what they had to do. But they did allow us to fill the tub up with water, put water here and there. They did allow that. I thank them for that. So we do have water to flush our toilets. I thank them for that. We do have water to cook. I thank them for that. But I do not thank them for the way they handled the situation. These are family lives. Water is a necessity. These are family lives. When you play with family lives in this city, you're not just playing with your life because you go home to water. Yes, your bills are paid. My bills are paid too. But I'm suffering because now you telling me that I cannot live what I paid. You are telling me that my house is not suitable for me and my family because you choose to turn the water off. You choose not to pay your bills. We are the victims here. The word is victimized. We have been violated. We have been persecuted. In other words, we've been judged without a jury because they took it upon themselves to make their judgment against us, not against the landlord. The landlord, do you really honestly think the landlord is really going to care if these families are really suffering, even though he's going back and forth with the city? Do you honestly really think that? No.
We have a major problem in Troy with blighted and abandoned homes, and with the water shut off, at least that is a good thing. so there's not going to be that kind of potential damage. But now that the house is vacant and it is known to be vacant, that invites another element into that, into the community and into this community that does not need any more vacant homes. So I'm very disturbed and upset that this is the way that things had to unfold today. It also upsets me that, you know, the city, and I speak about the royal we, but the city is also partly to blame in allowing what has occurred to have happened. To have a residential water bill reach the value that it reached over this amount of time, and to take action at this point is also unconscionable. And again, the people caught in the middle, the residents, the families, the people who live in these homes, they're the victims here, and they're the most vulnerable victims, especially when their rent is now something they have to take recourse to recover. And I'm sure that that rent was spent in good faith, that those homes are going to be available and those houses were going to be available for them to live in through the winter, through the end of the fall into the winter. And now that money is in limbo right now. So it's very disturbing to me. My heart goes out to the families that are affected by this, and I wish that things were done differently and that a more civilized outcome could have been handled today.
We're all affected. He's sitting up in Clifton Park right now, enjoying his life, has running water, is able to have his kids brush their teeth and lay down and go to sleep, when I have to worry about where I'm gonna have my kids brush their teeth and, you know, take their baths and everything. And he has no respect for anybody. I appreciate everything that these two and him over here have done for us, because without them, none of this would have been started. Just like they said, the community, if it wasn't for them, we'd be nowhere, because obviously the city is not trying to help us. He's obviously not trying to help us, and as in he, I mean Greg, is not trying to help us. It's just, I'm glad that, you know, we have, you know, these people to help us, but in the same sense, it shouldn't be up to these people. He, as a man, should have taken care of this. And I feel that the city is also to blame, because, like, you know, this young man just said, how do you let a bill get up to $9,000? How do you? I know I could speak for myself, and I'm pretty sure I could speak to every last one of these families up here. If we would have been known about this situation well before it got to $9,000, I'm pretty sure for our well-being and our children's well-being, we would have did whatever we had to do to make sure that water bill was paid. And I just feel that he is at the point right now where he don't care what goes on with these families. And, you know, it's a very sad thing, and sad to say, this is what we have in Troy. And I just want better for my kids. I want better for everybody else that is affected by this. Like I said, I'm not the only one. They're not the only ones. There's numerous of us out here. And this might not be the only landlord that is doing this. There, I'm pretty sure there's others. Something has got to give. Something has got to give when it comes to us citizens of Troy. And pretty much, like I said, I just want to thank everybody that has done everything in their possibilities to do this, because now, once again, I just moved from South Troy back in May to Greg's, you know, property up on 2nd Ave, switched my kids' schooling because I wanted a better school for them. And now, guess what? I have to go back to South Troy, and I have to switch my schools once again. So now this is two schools that my kids will be in, and we're only in the second month of school. It's ridiculous. I'm glad he's brought to light, and now everybody is warned of him, and hopefully we're all ridden of him now.
I grew up in this neighborhood, and I've been a lifelong tenant. And one of the issues I have with what has happened to Mac and his family and all of the other families, and more specifically the children, is that their rights are not being taken into consideration here. More often than not, I have heard from city staffers that we have to be concerned with property owner rights. Well, what about tenant rights? It's about time the conversation starts on tenant rights. When a tenant remits the rent payment, they do so with the understanding and agreement that they have the right to a warranty of habitability. The reason these families are without homes right now is that their property owner didn't feel that was an important right for them. He failed to pay his bills. The way the city rules work, they don't notify the tenants that the water bill wasn't paid. They notify the property owner again and again and again. And they depend on the property owner to notify his or her tenants. Now, I'm standing here to tell you, I've never had a property owner notify me he was behind on his bills. Have any of the other tenants had that happen? I don't think so. It's time we have a true conversation about tenants' rights. Just because we are tenants and considered transients, we're not bad people. We put down deep roots in our city. I've lived in every single neighborhood in this city, and I consider that a blessing, to have been able to be exposed to all the different neighborhoods and the idiosyncrasies of those neighborhoods. I, too, experienced having to move from one school district to another as a young child. I will tell you from personal experience, it's extraordinarily disruptive to the education of a child. Exactly. In fact, I didn't learn basic math until high school because the way I moved, I was learning addition and subtraction in one school district, moved to the other school district, and they're doing multiplication and division. Well, I still hadn't figured out 2 + 2. This is the same type of situation that some of these children are being put in now. What about their rights? Some serious consideration has to be taken as we move through this comprehensive plan, which is also supposed to focus on code and zoning. Well, let's focus a little on tenants' rights too.
Even though that water is off, there is nothing that says that water has to stay off. Just like the decision was made to turn it off, you can turn it back on. Do the right thing. Don't put these families through something that is not any fault of their own. Show the world that Troy is a bigger place than a dollar bill, that people matter here. And that's why we stand up here today to ask you to remember that we are human beings. We deserve to be respected as such. We are not your victim. We are the strongest asset that you will ever have. And every last one of us counts. Do the right thing. Turn the water on. Hold the person responsible that's supposed to be held responsible and not make other families suffer. They're not the first and they won't be the last, but they sure nobody should be able to lay in their bed tonight with any type of conscience and say that they did the right thing and leave that water off. Turn the water on, Mr. Mayor, I'm begging you. Please, turn it on. Do the right thing.